Government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Richard Wood with Z News. We are live, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you once again for joining us for this, the sixth podcast edition of Z News, which is a compendium of information on business, finance, economics, and social and political issues worldwide, reaching over 10,000 subscribers via email newsletter, which typically runs to about 40 pages each edition, twice a week, and also via hard copy posted to you twice a month. It is Sunday, the 30th day of January 2011. Coming up on the show today, working through the worst recession since the 1930s, currency traders feel pain, food riots around the world, and Wall Street shills hard at work. The US economy is still reaping the whirlwind of malinvestment that is yet to be unwound, which continues to destroy capital. The intercession by the Fed and the agencies delayed the residential housing collapse but didn't stop it, and it has not been a solution. Very low interest rates have been in place, but most buyers cannot even afford 3.5% cash down. In addition, the available housing inventory for sale monthly grows. Slow growth and lower rates have not been a solution. In fact, without the Fed and its loan programs and returning to the subprime Alt-A loans, all the major lenders would have gone under, and their financial situation is no better now than it was 4 years ago. The pyramid scheme that was housing was a giant financing device, as homeowners pulled out equity once a year and used that cash to buy second and third homes. The lenders knew they shouldn't have been doing what they were doing, but they did it anyway. The result is today, some 25% of homes have negative equity, which we believe will become 25% worse over the next 2 years. That means more walkaways and more overhanging inventory. There is nothing less than systemic failure. In the housing collapse, most Americans had a major loss of wealth occur. Half of Americans were using their homes as a hedge for retirement. In most cases, their only real savings vehicle, only to have that vehicle smashed by the Fed, government, and imprudent banks. This was the destruction of the dreams of millions of Americans. Capital was drained into the real estate cauldron, and today We have millions of empty homes, malls, and stores. This capital should have been used to build plant and equipment and in research and development. That was difficult under the circumstances because of the lack of need of such job-creating facilities. This was caused by free trade, globalization, and outsourcing. Over the last 11 years, America's lost 8.5 million jobs and 42,400 businesses to foreign countries. Without tariffs to level the playing field, there was no need for investment. So the outlet to help the economy from collapsing was real estate construction. That was, and still is, consumption. That is keeping the economy afloat, along with endless amounts of funds for the financial sector and little or nothing for the average American. This consumption, which is 70% of GDP, is still in force in the US dead-born economy. Still no solutions, but there can be a solution as we lose millions of jobs a year to transnational conglomerates which ship these good-paying jobs overseas in a relentless effort to totally destroy the American economy. This is the same group of elitists who want to bring $1.9 trillion in profits again back into the US at 5.25% taxation, which will cost the taxpayer $650 billion in lost taxation. Money that instead flows to corporate shareholders and into the pockets of management of these corporations as the funds are used to jack up the markets and buy treasury and agency bonds. This is all at your expense. All these elements have been employed to take down the US economy and pauperize the American people in an attempt to make them accept world government. You now are experiencing the legacy of Keynesian corporatist fascism and the destructive forces unleashed by Sir Alan Greenspan. As we see from the trillions of dollars pumped into the economy by the Fed, is the bailout of the financial sector and over-the-top speculation and unbelievable fraud from the criminal cabal running New York City, Washington, and the nation. Only in America can a Defense Department announce it cannot find trillions of dollars, or where the administration of Iraq, $50 billion, disappears as American citizens starve on the streets. Everywhere you look, there is fraud and criminal acts, yet mysteriously no one ever goes to jail. The residential home mortgage market has been destroyed and probably won't recover for many years to come. The Fed probably will have to create money and credit for years to come to stave off the failure of the financial system and the persistent undertow of deflation. As you have been taught, the giant banks, brokerage houses, and insurance companies are too big to fail. That means they will continue to have a license to steal. Front running and naked shorting will rise to even greater heights with the complicity of the criminal SEC and CFTC. The corruption that is overwhelming will worsen each and every day. Then again, for the past 15 years, Goldman Sachs has controlled the revolving door at the Treasury Department, and JP Morgan has controlled the Fed since its inception. These are the gang leaders who control America. These are the same people who control the American media so that you won't know what is really going on. The brainwashing and psychological warfare against the American people is relentless. the supposed current recovery is being underpinned by zero interest rates, with real inflation hovering around 6.75%. We are told by Bloomberg that current high gold and silver prices, a result in part of those zero rates, is a craze, and CNBC calls it a bubble. They don't call the bond market a bubble, which it is. Evidently, they attach no significance to the fact that 10-year Treasury note just catapulted from a yield of 2.4% to 3.5%. In the world of CNBC, CNN, and Bloomberg, up is down and down is up. It is also evident that governmental deficits will never be liquidated unless, of course, Washington steals American $6 trillion in 401ks and IRAs, which they have every intention of doing. The bill has been prepared, and our politicians in Wall Street are waiting for the right moment to jam it through. Just think of it. A lifetime of work wiped out in the blink of an eye. If you have these plans, you had better think about liquidating them before it's too late. Gold has become again the world reserve currency. It is just that few realize the transition has already taken place. For the past 11 years, every major currency has fallen in value versus gold from 13 to 20% annually. Versus silver, the figures range from 17 to 25%. This is a clear-cut, ominous trend of a flight away from all currencies to gold and silver, and quite a flight to safety. This movement by worldwide investors cannot be ignored. There obviously are many people that see what we see, and in that process are dumping currencies for gold and silver-related assets. Unfortunately, Americans are far behind in these changes, with only 2% of the population participating. Ladies and gentlemen, the second stage of the gold and silver bull market has just begun. Prices have fallen from their highs. What a great time to buy! Before signing off today, we would like to thank all of our subscribers for making these broadcasts happen. None of this would have been possible without your continued valuable support. Listeners are able to follow me on Twitter at Richard J. Wood or the Zed News feed on my Facebook fan page for the latest stories we are following. On the program tomorrow, economy still stagnant despite money injections. US and Europe won't be able to repay most of their debts. And free trade, globalization, and the phony terrorism all linked together. Be sure to join us then. I'm Richard Wood, and this has been Zed News. Because you can handle the truth.